Hey guys, Dylan from the Geek Duo here, and today I'll be bringing you my reaction to My Hero Academia Season 5, Episode 16, titled Long Time No See, Selkie. Yuuku brings her work study students with her when Selkie asks her to team up with him. So, this is another anime-only episode. Much like, well, Selkie's episode in the first internship arc, well, or the Versus the Hero Killer arc, as it's actually called, but yeah, I had a feeling they'd sort of have to do at least one of these, considering this arc that they're doing isn't actually that long. Like, it's, to be honest, I don't actually remember how long it is. I'm going to guess 12 chapters. Let me check if I'm right. No, 11. It's 11 chapters of the manga, and we already got, counting next week's episode, 5 for this arc. That's less than that. Well, that's more than the average episodes we have for equivalent pages in previous chapters, which is, well, no, they're usually 2.3, and we're running almost 2. So, yeah, more episodes for less chapters, meaning if they're going to stretch this to the end of the season, A, it explains why we've gotten so many flashbacks this season. B, it explains why there's so much extra added to scenes so far, and we're going to need at least one or two more anime-only episodes, because I doubt they're going to start the next arc this season, considering how long it is, and unless they're going to stop halfway through it, but I don't really see how they can, then they've got 5 more episodes that they need to fill with content. And, well, no, I guess I can see a point in that arc where they could stop it, and that's the arrival at the city. For those who know the arc, they'll know the point I'm talking about. No one else will, but yeah. That's the only point in that arc I can see them stopping for the chapter break. Well, not chapter break, the season end. Anyway, I've been rambling. Let's get this filler episode started in 3, 2, 1, go. Okay. I thought it wasn't playing. I know I'm sounding critical of it, but I don't like things that are, like, so there's a certain chronology in the manga, and then they've just cut and swapped arcs, and I don't like that. Plus, this does seem to have a lot more flashbacks and filler than other seasons, so. I mean, I'm surprised they didn't stretch Bakugo's fight over 2 episodes rather than half an episode, and the other half being filler. But yeah. don't get me wrong, I like the arc, so I like what they've done with it. It's just the season is not the best in my opinion. Oh, we're getting her new costume. We weren't meant to find out about this till the end. I feel we've met her before. The one with the scarf. You've got to treat your interns good. Give them a little dessert every now and then. The one good thing about filler episodes is, well, A, it flushes out the back characters, like what we're getting with, well, they're not exactly back characters, but they are for this arc, Sue and Uraraka. But, yeah. Now, if we're going to also get snippets of the others, so, I'm assuming, well, I'm not really assuming it, I'm hoping that half, well, the equivalent of half this episode is focused on the Sue story, well, Selkie story, but, and we get snippets of everyone else, at least of the main eight of Class 1A. That is a look. Her face seems sharper than normal. Interesting. That did seem like a more refined Well, you are on a boat. I just realized that the back of her dress is probably open so that it doesn't tear from her wings. I've never put too much thought into it. It's nice to see that someone else thinks it's cute, as well as Froppy. How comparatively serious is. She ate the turtle. Interested to see what your quirks are. Yellow. I was hoping for a, like, transformation sequence, but we've got no idea how she transforms, so it makes sense there wasn't one. Oh, sorry about that. I'm pretty sure Sue would still need to breathe, though, occasionally. I have to check something after this episode. And those would probably also be amplified by her earpieces. Okay, so we're probably not going to see that guy's quirk at all. A hydroplane. Yeah, there was no way her tongue was catching a plane. That's one way to... She's got four grapple things from each wrist. Do you know how to fly this? Pull up. You push down to go down, or is that just a helicopter, not a plane? I've never thought about eating clams in that with chopsticks. Poor Selkie. You've still got two people that think it's cute. Well, we didn't get to tune in with anyone else. A little disappointing, but that was a interesting episode. Definitely not top tier. Nothing overly good about it, nothing overly bad about it. So, it was just an episode. Can't think of anything to talk about. Like, we got introduced to Uraraka's new outfit early. There's that, I guess. Yeah, no, nothing in that episode was important other than Uraraka's outfit. Like, Selkie doesn't even show up in the manga as of currently. Oh. That's what it's doing. It's setting up the movie. Right. Well, that explains it then. Did you not know that? I could have sworn Midoriya knew at least about Fuyumi. I think Shoto's mentioned his sister before. Natsuo, no, I don't think he's ever actually openly spoken about him, but... Okay, we're using this episode as a soft setup for the third movie that's coming out. Apparently that's going to be taking place in Europe, I guess. Like, the first one dealt with Americans. I don't know what the second one dealt with. I think it was purely Japanese people. So this one's going to be in Europe. Okay. Hey, maybe if there's a fourth movie, it'll be set in my home turf. No, Japan is too close to Australia for them to warrant setting a movie set here. Ah, well. But yeah, that... There was a very unimportant episode. It wasn't bad. I just wish it had have been more. It followed almost the exact same beats as Sue and Selkie's last episode. Just different villains. And the inclusion of Yuku and Ochako. But, yeah. Anyway, I'm gonna end this recording here. Catch you in the next one.